scrutinised as well. It was done. It was done spring last year, and I'd hoped that we'd have a report to the forum for discussion, because clearly a historical line in the budget, if the forum and council had agreed that, could have been claimed to be in this new national funding formula as an historical cost if the council had put this as a line in the formula. I think we missed the boat there personally, but we can't argue about that. But I do think perhaps we need to go back and look at these figures as a working party.
Chair, if I could just clarify, the census that the alleged referring to is the council space in 2013-14 crisis. What that means is that the PFI costs are compared with non-PFI schools using 2013-14. It is not using 2013-14 PFI costs. They are the PFI costs post benchmark.
This is due to a lot of work that the school
tools have done, taking on board all the issues that we've been talking about, you know, making sure that when they're looking at their projections, they are making sure that the projections are reasonable and not saying, oh, we set that budget last year, so we'll just put that again. They have been looking at how they can make sure that their budgets are balancing within sort of like a year without taking balances into account. My team, the RS team and HR have been working with schools where their deficit budgets were looking particularly bad and have started quite big inroads onto reducing those balances and planning for reduction of hours and possible reduction of staff where necessary. There's been plenty of briefings and discussions with heads and with the school finance staff. So, you know, the awareness out there is really good and it is making huge differences to what schools' balance are looking like. And we'll continue this over the next couple of months when we do budget setting and start the process again and making sure that we're looking at as well as the current year, what then the 17-18 budgets are looking like and make sure that we're keeping on top of those. Obviously, with all the changes that we've talked about, the national funding formula, that could well have difference, you know, bring on further issues that we need to be reviewing as well. And we've also seen
some
evidence.
Thanks, Lassie. Any comments on that? And it shows you that improved picture is sort of some very hard work on the whole college round here in making sure they manage their school budgets more effectively. Thank you. Okay, item 15, which is the budget update, Andrew.
Yes, this is a very brief talk of course, and from the budget report in January, it reflects pretty much the confirmation from the Education Funding Agency about the academy adjustments. Largely, the budget of what we saw in January to $43 million, reduced by around about $70 million for the academies. So the report runs through a number of changes in primary and secondary budgets in early years and high needs. It's confirmed the high needs places and gives a very brief update on the current position with regards to city learning centres and funding and the school staff service.
Thank you. Thank you for keeping it brief as well. Any comments on that? Okay, that report is noted. Thank you very much, Andrew. A very quick one from you, Sue, which is the forum update, the mansion update.
We bring this report quite often just to keep up updates on where the membership is up to. We've probably got the 30 members in total. We probably need to review the nursery representative, so we'll do that shortly. And we need to contact the school staff, the school non-teaching staff about it and on staff in RAG. The split between primary and secondary academy have to be based on pupil numbers. I've updated that based on January census and the ratios are still coming out the same, so that's okay. Obviously, as schools start moving, as some of the primary start moving to academy, then that split will start changing and we'll obviously have to keep an eye on how that representation works. The next table just gives an indication of when the terms of office are and when they are due to end. So keep an eye on that. We have a new primary teacher representative, Vicky Lightwing, as we replaced Mona Walker, who's recently retired. We've got two new primary governor reps, Steve Dainty and Andy Herring. And I've mentioned that the other two need to be filled. And the report's just a note.
Thank you very much, Sue. And finally, if you can just hold up the work on it.